Andy here, day 6 for the spoilers of Innistrad's Crimson Vow. Finally, we are seeing some good vampires in this so-called vampire set. Let's start. And I want to start with Sanctify. For 1 and 1 white, it's a sorcery, destroy target artifact or enchantment, you gain 3 life. Scatter Toss for 3 and 1 blue, it's an instant, look at the top 4 cards of your library, put 2 of those cards into your hand and the rest into your graveyard. Reckless Impulse for 1 and 1 red, it's a sorcery, exile the top 2 cards of your library, until the end of your next turn you may play those cards. Mulch for 1 and 1 green, it's a sorcery, reveal the top 4 cards of your library, put all land cards revealed this way into your hand and the rest into your graveyard. Weaver of Blossoms for 2 and 1 green, it's a 2-3, it's a human werewolf, tap and add 1 mana of any color. It has Daybound, which means that when it's day, it's Weaver of Blossoms, when it's night, it's Blossom Clad Werewolf, it's a 3-4, tap, add 2 mana of 1 color. Honor's Heirloom for 3, it's an artifact, tap, add 1 mana of any color, 2, tap, exile target card from a graveyard. Thirst for Discovery, 2 and 1 blue, it's an instant, draw 3 cards, then discard 2 cards, unless you discard a basic land card. Heroes Downfall for 1 and 2 black, it's an instant, destroy target creature or Prince Walker. Remember that Heroes Downfall was rare, now it's downgraded to uncommon. Edgar's Awakening 3 and 2 black, it's a sorcery, return target creature card from your graveyard to the battlefield. When you discard it, you may pay 1 black, if you do, return target creature card from your graveyard to your hand. Alluring Sweeter for 2 and 1 red, it's a 2-3, it's a vampire, when you attack with exactly 2 creatures, transform it, and then transform into Deadly Dancer, it's a 3-3 with Trample, when this creature transforms into Deadly Dancer, add 2 red mana until end of turn, you don't lose this mana as steps and phases end. For 2 red, it gets and another target creature each get +1/+0 until end of turn. Mark of Retaliation for 2 and 1 red, it's a sorcery, choose one or both. Creatures you control get +1/+0 until end of turn. Target vampire you control deals damage equal to its power to another target creature. Into the Night for 3 and 1 red, it's a sorcery, it becomes night. Discard any number of cards, then draw that many cards +1. Roombound Wolf for 1 and 1 red, it's a 2-2. For 3 and 1 red, tap, it deals damage equal to the number of wolves and werewolves you control to target opponent. Honeymoon Hearse, and I can't imagine going on honeymoon on this type of vehicle. For 2 and 1 red, it's a 5-5 with trample, tap to untap creatures you control, it becomes an artifact creature until end of turn. Ancient Lumbernaut for 2, 1 black and 1 green, it's a 1-4. Each creature you control with toughness greater than its power assigns combat damage equal to its toughness rather than its power. Boarded Window, 3. It's an artifact, creatures attacking you get -1/-0. At the beginning of each end step, if you were dealt 4 or more damage this turn, exile it. Parasitic Grasp for 1 and 1 black, cleave 1 and 2 black. It deals 3 damage to target human creature, you gain 3 life. But if you pay the cleave cost, that is 1 and 2 black, then it deals 3 damage to target creature, you gain 3 life. Now it's the turn of rare cards. Patchwork Crawler for 1 and 1 blue, it's a 1-2. It's a zombie horror for 2 and 1 blue. Exile target creature card from your graveyard and put a +1/+1 counter on it. It has all activated abilities of all creature cards exiled with it. Blood Veil Purveyor for 2 and 2 black, it's a 5-6, yes. It's a 4 drop and it's a 5-6. Flying and Trample. Whenever an opponent casts a spell, that player creates a blood token. Whenever it attacks, it gets +1/+0 for each blood token defending player controls. Yes, it's a 4 drop, 5-6, flying and trample. The only disadvantage of this card is that whenever an opponent casts a spell, that player creates a blood token. But whenever it attacks, it gets +1/+0 for each blood token defending player's control. I think this is a very, very strong card. One last note, Wizard of the Coast just released a correction for this card. Its last ability, it's until end of turn. So be careful when using or facing this card. Dreadful Service for 2 and 1 black, it's an enchantment. Whenever you discard one or more cards, create a 2-2 black zombie creature token. This ability triggers only once each turn. Only one advice here, if you want a good service, don't hire zombies, especially for your wedding. Stancia Uprising for 2 and 2 red, it's an enchantment. At the beginning of your end step, create a 1-1 red human creature token. Then, if you control exactly 13 permanents, you may sacrifice it. When you do, it deals 7 damage to any target. I told you, 13 is a recurrent number in Innistrad. Headless Rider 2 and 1 black, it's a 3-1 zombie. Whenever it or another non-token zombie you control dies, create a 2-2 black zombie creature token. Graf Reaver for 1 and 1 black, it's a 3-3 with exploit. Whenever exploits a creature, destroy target planeswalker. At the beginning of your upkeep, it deals 1 damage to you. Glorious Sunrise for 3 and 2 green, it's an enchantment. At the beginning of combat, on your turn, choose 1. Creatures you control get +1/+1 and gain trample until end of turn. Target land gains. Tap, add 3 green mana until end of turn, draw a card if you control a creature with power 3 or greater, or you gain 3 life. mythic cards, and finally a vampire mythic. This is Crimson Vow, should be all about vampires. Henrika Domnati, 2 and 1 black, it's a 1/3 with flying. At the beginning of combat, on your turn, choose one that hasn't been chosen. Each player sacrifices a creature, you draw a card and you lose one life, or transform Henrika Domnati and you transform it into Henrika Infernal Seal. It's a 3/4 flying, death touch and lifelink. For 1 and 2 black, each creature controlled with flying, death touch and or lifelink gets a +1/+0 until end of turn. Honestly, as I said, finally a good mythic vampire. Crimson Vow should be all about vampires, but unfortunately we haven't seen very strong vampires until Henrika. There's also a Dracula series version of this card. Remember that Crimson Vow will have box toppers, and the box toppers will be one of these Dracula series cards, the three Weird Sisters, which transform into Fiends of Darkest Night. So that was the last card in this particular Day 6 spoilers for Innistrad Crimson Vow. Tune in tomorrow for more and more spoilers about this vampiric set. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more and more interesting videos about Magic the Gathering and the collectible world.